Philippines reports another record increase in COVID-19 infections for the second straight day. A total of 37,207 new cases were detected in the past 24 hours. COVID-19 cases in the Philippines have breached 3.1 million just 3 days after surpassing the 3 million mark. The number of active cases now at 265,000. The health department also recorded 81 additional deaths and 9,000 more recoveries. 8 labs were not able to submit data.
The implementation of strict COVID-19 protocols in Metro Manila and other areas in the Philippines extended for 2 more weeks. The government has retained the alert level 3 status in the National Capital Region until January 31st, as COVID-19 cases continue to rise. 54 more areas in the country, including Baguio City, Ilocos Sur, Bataan, Bulacan, and Pampanga, will also be under alert level 3. This means face-to-face classes are suspended, while contact sports and fun fairs in these areas are banned.
The government nonetheless remains focused on doing everything it can to prevent the spread of the disease and to manage its impact on our lives. Tuloy-tuloy po ang pag-aaral at diskusyon ng IATF sa mga eksperto para mas akma ang ating mga polisiya at guidelines sa evolving na situation na ito.
Meanwhile, 22 other areas including Apayao, Batanes, Palawan, Masbate, and Siquijor will be under the looser alert level 2 until the end of the month.
Despite the latest COVID surge, Philippine government lifts travel restrictions on red list countries. Malacanang has announced international travelers coming from high-risk countries, which include Spain, Saudi Arabia, and Canada, are now allowed to enter the Philippines, but they will be subject to several restrictions. A negative RT-PCR test result taken within 48 hours prior to departure is required. Travelers also need to undergo facility-based quarantine and take an RT-PCR test on the 7th day. Malacanang defends government's decision to lift the travel ban.
Dahil nga po, meron na po tayong cases ng Omicron at marami po tayong mga kababayan, halimbawa na nasa red list countries na gusto nang umuwi. At base sa dati nating protocols, kailangan po ng bayanihan flights para sila ay makauwi. Taking all of these into consideration, plus the fact na pag sila naman po ay mula sa red list countries, pag umuwi po sila dito sa atin at sumunod strictly doon sa ating quarantine protocols para sa red list, then we are assured naman na mas mababantayan natin.
Malacanang also says the Philippines will require foreign nationals entering the country to show proof of their COVID-19 vaccination starting February 16th.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque III seeks to allay the public's fears regarding the shortened isolation period for COVID-exposed persons. Under the new rule, the isolation period for vaccinated individuals who are asymptomatic or have mild COVID-19 will be shortened to 7 days. Their close contacts who are fully vaccinated would only have to isolate for 5 days. The unvaccinated or partially inoculated that are probable, mild, or asymptomatic cases will have to undergo isolation for 10 days. Duque says there's less risk of a further spread of the virus since more people are already vaccinated and have received booster shots.
The situation today is far different from what it was a year ago because now we have a much higher vaccination coverage. In fact, we have already vaccinated close to about 54 million Filipinos with completed inoculation and about 58 million with the first dose.
But the Coalition for People's Right to Health disagrees.
this aspect of reducing it to 7 days is based on a notion of an acceptable risk. You know? So how many, what is the percentage of the population that is less likely to be able to infect at the end of that time? And we have research showing that there is a significant decrease by the seventh day, but it is still not zero. It's still not even less than 5%. In the UK, they have to check if they test negative with lateral flow tests or antigen tests at day 5 or day 6. However, in the Philippines, we're just assuming, no, that these patients would not be infectious at the end of the 7th or 10th day of isolation.
The Philippine government releases simplified COVID-19 vaccination guidelines to encourage more Filipinos to get inoculated. Malacanang says walk-ins are now allowed. Some health screening processes have also been scrapped. Acting Presidential Spokesperson Carlo Nograles says clearance will only be required for individuals with an autoimmune disease, HIV, cancer, and other serious medical conditions.
Hindi na rin po kailangan bilang health screening ang pag-monitor sa blood pressure unless ang babakunahan ay may history ng hypertension or may sintomas ng hypertension at iba pang konsiderasyon na nakabase sa clinical judgment ng doktor sa vaccination site. May mga bakuna, mas maluwag na po ang requirements para dito, kaya wag na po tayong magdalawang isip, magpabakuna na po tayo.
Senator Sonny Angara maintains COVID-19 tests should be free of charge to the public. Angara says there is sufficient funding under the 2022 budget to cover such costs. He specifically mentions the 17.8 billion peso budget allocated for COVID-19 laboratory network commodities, which can be used by government to provide free tests. Angara adds government could also subsidize costs of RT-PCR tests done in privately operated labs through state insurer PhilHealth. He says the Senate pushed for bigger budget for COVID testing amid the raging pandemic.
The Health Department wants medical frontliners, senior citizens, and persons with comorbidities prioritized in COVID-19 testing. This so proper medicines would be given to them as early as possible. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergeri adds, persons exposed to symptomatic individuals who have yet to be tested are urged to isolate and look out for symptoms within 14 days.
Ang mga bagong gamot para sa COVID ay binibigay sa mga taong may matataas na posibilidad na maging severe ang simptomas at maospital. Ito ay ang ating mga senior citizens at ibang kapwa Pilipino na may sakit o comorbidities. Prioridad din po natin ang ating healthcare workers.